അല്ല സർ, ഞാൻ സംസാരിക്കുകയും സ്ലൈഡും കൂടെ ഒരുമിച്ച് ടോക്ക് അത് സാറ് നമ്മള് അത് സംസാരിക്കുമ്പോ താഴെ എഴുതി കാണിക്കുന്നു ടൈറ്റില്, അതാണ് സാർ
ഉദ്ദേശിക്കുന്നത്.
റിഹേഴ്സ് ചെയ്യുന്ന ഒരു സ്ലൈഡില് ഇത്ര ടൈം റിഹേഴ്സ് ചെയ്തിട്ട് അത് സെറ്റ് ചെയ്യും. അപ്പം ഇപ്പൊ ടോട്ടൽ 10 മിനിറ്റ്സിനുള്ളിൽ പ്രസന്റേഷൻ തീർക്കണമെങ്കിൽ അങ്ങനെ റിഹേഴ്സ് ചെയ്ത് വെച്ചിട്ട് ചെയ്യാം.
You finish your word work and then go. Okay.
Start.
That morning your word work will be over. So then afternoon, so now you can go to the lab and assess it. So that you get a group of things. നൈറ്റിൽ ഒക്കെ എന്തെങ്കിലും എമർജൻസീസ്
വന്നാലും. സോ ടുഡേ വി വിൽ ഡിസ്കസ് അബൌട്ട് കാർഡിയക് MRI. സോ ദി എയിം ഓഫ് ദ പ്രസന്റേഷൻ മെയിൻലി വിൽ ഡിസ്കസ് മോസ്റ്റ്ലി വിൽ ബി ഏബിൾ ടു കവർ ഓൺലി ദ MRI ഫിസിക്സ് ടുഡേ. ദൻ ഹൗ ടു പെർഫോം എ കാർഡിയക് MRI ഇൻക്ലൂഡിംഗ് ഓൾ ദ സ്റ്റെപ്സ് പ്രിപ്പറേഷൻ എവരിതിങ്. ദൻ വാട്ട് ആർ ദ ബേസിക് വ്യൂസ് ഓഫ് കാർഡിയക് MRI? ജസ്റ്റ് ലൈക്ക് വി ഹാവ് എക്കോ വ്യൂസ്, MRI also has some certain basic views. Then how do we identify each of the structures in each of the views, and what in various clinical conditions what is the appearance we get? So I've taken this reference mainly from this cardiac MRI Braunwald companion book is there. Then there is an atlas of cardiac, that is also Braunwald companion. Then there is a guideline, 2010 ACC guideline on cardiac MRI. And so this is what a cardiac MRI looks like, just like a routine MRI. Only thing is, for when you are doing a cardiac MRI, there will be a separate coil for cardiac. When we are doing cardiac structures, so the we will fix a separate coil on top of this. So MRI generally, when we are doing for any particular region, suppose we are doing for a cervical region, we have a separate coil kept to the cervical. For a brain, a separate coil for the brain. So like that, related to the structure we are targeting, we will keep separate coils for it.
What are the two systems that are available in MRI?
Parts of the MRI.
One is called closed system, the other will be open.
Open,
closed and open. Why? Because closed
claustrophobia.
It happened to my brother, but he ran away from this.
Me too.
Second time I went to another place with an open. He could see. Isn't there you are inside
this? We are inside this.
45 minutes at down this room. Now I am used to it because I have done about 2-3 times. First time it was a real
So
close and open. Open like this.
We are not entering into a tunnel. This
in
closed, actually we are entering in a tunnel, we will be strapped also. And suppose if we are doing a cervical MRI, for me I did a cervical MRI. So they will fix it everything and you have to stay still. And you will be entering the tunnel, it will be like lying inside a box. So even if suppose within the MRI also, suppose you feel like any discomfort, you cannot alert anyone also, because nobody will be there in the room. While the MRI is being done, only you will be there in the room. All the technician, everybody will be standing outside. So generally what they do is, at the hand of the patient, we give a panic button. So with that panic button, if at all you want to stop it, you can press the button and you can stop it at that time. So we cannot move at all actually, we'll be moving like this only. And if the radiologist want to give any instruction, it will come through the speaker. Because most of the time when we do cardiac MRI, patient has to hold the breath and all, breath holding thing will be there. So at that time, the instruction will come through the speaker. So this is just another picture. So that's for the anterior chest RF coil, we call our radio frequency coil, and we have an alert button here. And this. So coming to CMR physics, cardiac MRI physics, how is this being done? So it was, MRI was discovered in 1947, but it took many years later for that first clinical images to be obtained in 1975, and it was jointly discovered by these people. So here we can see that how they had discovered using experimenting on coils and all. So
Linda, there is a very interesting story about this. It is under waiting in China. Under 1947, the glaucoma person on Kandori Chengla, the MRI was given a Nobel Prize. The Nobel Prize was the Paul Arthur Burnham Mansfield and on board. And they, the little physician Raymond Damadian, he is a physician. He was the one who actually developed the clinical applications of MRI. Okay, and the entry in the Nobel Prize.
It was given to the physics.
Physicist. That was my approval and he was the Time magazine, the front, he had a photo of it. Because it was an unfair thing. He was the one who popularized the clinical applications. Okay. And the other two also did not get it.
So the basic principle is that our body is composed around 60-70% of water. So MRI relies on the magnetic properties of the hydrogen and present in water. So we know that hydrogen atom has one proton and an electron. So in MRI, what we target is a hydrogen ion, that is one electron removed from the atom of hydrogen. So there is essentially only a proton that is there. So based on this magnetic properties of this hydrogen ion or this proton, we do MRI and how will come in. So electron removed and we have only proton. So basically when we think is in the body, protons, only protons we need to think. So why only hydrogen? There is nothing hard fast rule that only hydrogen can be used, because even other atoms also may be present in the body, but the only thing is they should have some odd number of protons or something. So carbon, other elements also, even though when we apply this magnetic field, even though all the hydrogen protons align, the other elements also which are having an odd amount of this thing also will align. So it's not necessary that hydrogen ions only align. So basically what we are targeting is a proton, that is proton aligning into the magnetic field. So these are the basic components of a MRI, this thing. So I'll show this with this. This is very important. And so basically there are three components. One is, there is a primary magnetic field. So this is the strongest magnetic field, and it is a uniform magnetic field, very strong. And within this magnetic field comes the next two elements, that is the gradient coil and the RF coil. So this primary magnetic field is the strongest one. It is generated by passing current through a solid metal, and they create a very strong magnetic field. And this magnetic field is very strong. That is, when we say about, when we say 1.5 Tesla, so it is around 50,000 times the Earth's magnetic field. So that much strong it is, and it can even pull a person or metal objects into this magnetic field. So it's very...
40,000 times the magnetic field. So
next, after that comes the gradient coil and then the RF coil, which we now in the next few slides we'll step discuss each of these in detail. Magnet, primary magnetic field, gradient coil and the RF coil.
In the upper level of the confusion, and I think the magnetic field is there. The magnetic field is any protons align there. So will it not cause any abnormality in the structure of the body when people are feeling it? നമ്മുടെ ശരീരത്തിൽ പല ഡയറക്ഷനിലുള്ളത് എല്ലാം കിടക്കുന്നുണ്ട്. ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് നോട്ട് ഇൻ എ സിംഗിൾ പ്ലെയിൻ. ഹൗ ഓൾ ദിസ് ഈസ് ഹാപ്പനിങ് ഇൻസൈഡ് ദ സെൽ. വാട്ടർ ഇസ് ത്രൂ ഔട്ട് ദ ബോഡി. അപ്പൊ ഈ വെള്ളത്തിന്റെ ഹൈഡ്രജൻ അയൺസ് നമ്മൾ എടുക്കുന്നത്, ആ ഹൈഡ്രജൻ അയൺസിന്റെ ഇങ്ങനെ ഒറ്റ ഡയറക്ഷൻ തന്നെ ആക്കിയാല് എന്തെങ്കിലും പറ്റുമോ എന്ന് പറയാൻ പറ്റില്ല. എനിക്ക് ഇപ്പോഴും ഒരു ഫീലിംഗ് കിട്ടും. ഞാൻ പറഞ്ഞ മനസ്സിലായി, വെൻ യു ആർ പുട്ട് ഇൻ ദ മാഗ്നറ്റിക് ഫീൽഡ് യു ആർ അലൈൻഡ് ടു ദാറ്റ് മാഗ്നറ്റിക് ഫീൽഡ്, ഡയറക്ഷൻ ഓഫ് ദാറ്റ് മാഗ്നറ്റിക് ഫീൽഡ്. അപ്പൊ ഈ ഹൈഡ്രജൻ അയൺസ് മുഴുവൻ അതിൽ അലൈൻ ചെയ്താൽ ശരീരത്തിൽ എന്തെങ്കിലും ഉണ്ടാവുമോ എന്നാണ് വാട്ട് റിയലി ഹാപ്പൻസ് എന്നുള്ള ഐ ഹാവ് നോട്ട് ബീൻ ഏബിൾ ടു
അണ്ടർസ്റ്റാൻഡ്.
അത് ആക്ച്വലി
ഫസ്റ്റ് തിങ് വെൻ യു ആർ എൻട്രിങ് ദ മാഗ്നറ്റിക് ഫീൽഡ്, യുവർ യുവർ ബോഡി ഈസ് അലൈൻഡ് ടു ദി ഡയറക്ഷൻ ഓഫ് മാഗ്നറ്റിക് ഫീൽഡ്. അതാണ് അതിന്റെ ഫസ്റ്റ് പ്രിൻസിപ്പിൾ തന്നെ. ദെൻ ദെൻ കംസ് ദി നെക്സ്റ്റ് തിങ്.
സോ the basic principle is, there is a magnetic field. When the body enters into this chamber, primary magnetic field, all the protons in that person's body will be aligned in that direction. So there are three axes actually. So when we enter the body, that axis is the z axis. So and that z axis is called the B0 or the primary magnetic field. That is in the direction the body enters, that is the z axis. So what the basic principle is, in that magnetic field, when it aligns in one direction, we use a radio frequency signal that will be sent in pulses. So that will be sent in pulses to this magnetic field, so that the alignment of the protons which are aligned in one direction will be changed. It will be flipped. That we call as a flip. And that flip will be done at a particular angle, which we call the flip angle. So all these protons will be flipped, and then when these protons return back to their original this thing, it will liberate energy. So this is just the basic outline, but we'll go into the details now. So we use a magnetic field and use a radio frequency to trigger it, the this thing. So the primary magnetic field, I told, in the z axis, so that is what we call as a longitudinal magnetization. Actually, in that direction, that we have a longitudinal magnetization, and there is a transverse magnetization also. So when the magnet field is not applied, all these when it is applied, all these protons will align in one direction. But it is not necessary that all the 100% will align, but there is some 5% that will be aligned to the opposite direction. That is also there. So that applied field is called the B0. So some will align the opposite. So it will have a net magnetic vector towards the main magnetic field. So I told in the Z axis, in the direction the body enters, so all are aligned in one direction. Now, what is precision? This is a concept that we'll be discussing when we tell about the radio frequency pulse, everything. My MRI sequences, everything is there. So this concept is coming in between. So I thought I'll discuss this precision actually. Precision generally means spinning, but it's not the typical spinning which we think of. It is actually, there is some physics to it. So I'll show this video. I think I'll show this video. So we'll see this top, this spinning top. Suppose we keep it like that, it will fall down. But when we are spinning, you can see how it is spinning. It's not spinning in a straight line. It is moving like into the inner plane like this. So that movement is called the precession. So just with one more video, I'll show. This is a gyroscope. So precession, they explain in physics by how this gyroscope spins actually. So we can see that if this gyroscope is not turned, like we do this thing, it will fall down like that. But actually this inner disc is a small magnet and it is kept cased in a metal this thing. So when we spin it like using a thread and we keep it, we can see it will spin, but the spin will have a jiggly effect. It will, so that movement is the precession. We'll keep it on the floor. Now that thing is rotating, see. So it is, even though the inside is spinning, it will move like a this thing. So this concept, this mechanism, I explained why, because the protons in the hydrogen atom undergo a spinning like this. That is, the protons by themselves will spin, because an individual proton itself will spin, and this will rotate around an axis, just like the Earth rotates around the sun. This itself will rotate around an axis, so that rotation will go in a particular sequence. That is called the precession. So that rotation is called, that there will be a rate, that is this much times in 1 second. Like, so the higher the magnetic field we give, the faster that precession rate. So when we have 1.5 tesla and 3 tesla, the 3 tesla will have a more faster precision rate, and because that precision rate is higher, you get more clarity and more resolution with the 3 tesla compared to 1.5 tesla. So the stronger the magnetic field, the precision rate will increase. So that is what we called precision. So now I've told that the protons, these red small dots are the protons, and they will spin around, called precession. Now these protons, there will be several protons that will be spinning. So when two protons spin together, process together, it is called in phase. And when several protons spin with one process at a different rate, another process at a different rate, that is out of phase. So this concept also will be coming. So processing in phase and out of phase.
The Hammer frequency is the rate of precession.
Rate of precession, the speed at which this thing. So Larmor frequency is one we can adjust with the magnetic field strength. So this is a 1.5 tesla will give a Larmor frequency of 63.9 megahertz, that is 63 per second. So higher tesla, higher speed of precession. So that was the primary magnetic field I told you, which is the strongest and the outermost magnetic field. Now within that primary magnetic field, there are gradient coils. These gradient coils, why they are named so, because they can give magnetic a secondary magnetic fields in gradients. And there are three coils, that is three coils in each of the plane, that is the Z axis, X axis and the Y axis. So in each of these planes, it can give a magnetic gradient. So that is what we call as a magnetic gradient. So gradient coils, So these are the this will show the picture of the three magnetic units. So we have the Z coil that is oriented left, then this red thing is the X coil and the yellow thing is the Y coil. So these three will give a gradient coil. Now these gradient coils will alter the strength of the primary magnetic field, and it will alter it can the based on the setting it can alter the precession frequency also. So the Z gradient that is along the long axis is the main thing that we use for slice selection. Suppose we want to take a particular slice and base that, so Z is the one we generally use, one gradient only, that is most commonly the Z gradient. That so that is why it is called the slice selection gradient. The Y is called the frequency encoding gradient, and Z is the phase encoding gradient. So these are the three types of coils available. Now comes the radio frequency coil. Now the first two steps I was talking about only magnet. This is a radio frequency signal which is different from the magnet. So radio frequency, you know, so it will transmit a radio frequency pulse just like our radio is.
It transmits a radio frequency and it receives a signal.
So it will transmit a radio frequency pulse to this magnetic field that is created by the primary as well as the gradient coil magnet, and then because of that, just like I told you, the protons will go into a flipping, and after flipping they go back to the original magnetization field. During that time it will release energy, and this energy will be can be received as a radio frequency signal by this RF coil. So that it is that signal that we take and compute, and we process using mathematical and the computer formulas, and we convert into an image. So it is by this thing. So
I got an imagination like
we can compare this like a plane lake where the water is stationary, come and go. So that lake we can compare it to a magnetic field, and we drop a stone into that lake, so it will create a ripple and we hear a sound, so we get a something back. So that thing we assess and process as a image.
Yeah, like, that is convert in radio frequency coil.
That radio frequency coil detect that signal. Pinna we need an computer to process that.
Fourier signals are nammala catalog la cheyina vale one form of energy is transmitted to transfer into another form nu parayunnathu pressure is transferred to your signal and same thing happens.
So the RF coil for different body region is like out. For brain we have a different thing. For leg, for cardiac MRI, this is the coil. So, what the radio frequency?
This is the brain.
This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is the brain. This is
Second time I simply slept. First time I was very caught up.
ഒരു ദിവസം പോയി ഞാൻ പറഞ്ഞ് അറിയാം മറ്റേ അവിടെ തന്നെ പഠിച്ചു അടുത്ത് തന്നെ അപ്പം ഒന്ന് കണക്ട് ചെയ്യാതെ ചുമ്മാ ഒന്ന് കേറ്റാൻ പറഞ്ഞു കേട്ടിട്ട് അവർ ചുമ്മാ ട്രോൾ അങ്ങോട്ട് കേട്ടാ അപ്പത്തേക്ക് തന്നെ ഞാൻ എനിക്ക് ചേട്ടറി പിന്നെ ദെൻ ഐ വെൻ സെർച്ചിങ് ഫോർ ഓപ്പൺ MRI ഇൻ ദാറ്റ് ഏരിയ ദെൻ കുഡന്റ് ഫൈൻഡ് ദെൻ അഗെയിൻ നെക് പെയിൻ വാസ് ദേർ അൾട്ടിമേറ്റ്ലി ഒന്നുകൂടെ പോയി ഒന്ന് അക്കോമഡേറ്റ് ചെയ്ത് കുറച്ചു നേരം കിടന്ന് നോക്കിയപ്പോൾ പിന്നെ ഫൈനലി ഡിഡ് ഇറ്റ് സോ വാട്ട് ദിസ് റേഡിയോ ഫ്രീക്വൻസി കോയിൽസ് ഇറ്റ് വിൽ ക്രിയേറ്റ് എ ഡിസ്റ്റർബൻസ് ഇൻ ദാറ്റ് പ്രോട്ടോൺ അലോൺമെന്റ് സോ ദ ലോ എനർജി പ്രോട്ടോൺസ് വിൽ ഫ്ലിപ് ടു എ ഹയർ എനർജി ലെവൽ and the protons will persist in phase just I told earlier so when this these are the two things that will happen when we give a radio frequency pulse that is it will flip to a higher energy level here we can see that the all the protons aligned in one this thing so all the protons here this top the small red dot is a proton so though after this radio frequency is given it will flip back it will flip to a different angle and this angle we can call as the flip angle so it is flipping to a different this thing
this is the coil la na principle inge rendu moonu na undalo one basic magnetic field pinne vera oru magnetic field undalo
gradient coils adu
moonu undu gradient coils moonu direction undalo longitudinal transverse and
coronal sagittal ഇങ്ങനെ മൂന്ന് പ്ലെയിൻസ്
അതിന്റെയാണ് ഇത് എനിക്ക് പ്രിൻസിപ്പിൾ മനസ്സിലായത് എനിക്ക് എന്റെ തലപ്പുറ പോയത് ഒരു റീജൻ സപ്പോസ് യു വാണ്ട് ദ അപ്പൊ അവിടെ ഈ ഒരു റീജൻ ഓഫ് ആ റീജൻ ഓഫ് ഇൻട്രസ്റ്റ് ഗ്രേഡിയന്റ് ഉണ്ടാക്കാനായിട്ടായിരിക്കും
ഇതില് മെയിൻ ഡിഫറൻസ് പ്രൈമറി മാഗ്നറ്റിക് ഫീൽഡിന്റെ ഫീൽഡ് യൂണിഫോം ആണ് പക്ഷെ ഇതില് ഒരു ഗ്രേഡിയന്റ് മാഗ്നറ്റിക് ഫീൽഡ് ആണ് എന്നുവെച്ചാൽ ഇറ്റ് വിൽ ബി സ്ട്രോങ്ർ അറ്റ് വൺ സൈഡ് ഇറ്റ് വിൽ ബി വീക്കർ അറ്റ് ദി അദർ സൈഡ് ആൻഡ് ദാറ്റ് ഓൾസോ ഇറ്റ് കാൻ ക്രിയേറ്റ് ഇൻ ത്രീ ഡിഫറെന്റ് പ്ലെയിൻസ്
ഗ്രേഡിന്റെ പർപ്പസ് ആണ് ഞാൻ ഇങ്ങനെ എന്തിനാണ് ഗ്രേഡിയന്റ് അതാണ് ശരിക്കും ഈ ഒരു ഇമ്പൾസ് കൊണ്ടിരുന്നത് ആ ഇമ്പൾസ് വരുമ്പോഴാണ് ഈ ഫ്ലിപ്പ് ചെയ്യുന്നത് തിരിച്ചു വരുന്നത് ആ ചേഞ്ചിന്റെ ഫ്ലിപ്പ് ആംഗിൾസ് എല്ലാം കമ്പ്യൂട്ട് ചെയ്താണ് ഈ ഗെറ്റ് ദി ഇമേജ്
ഗ്രേഡിയന്റ് കോയിൽ സാർ ഇതാണ് ഈ നമ്മള് ആ ഉണ്ടക്കകത്ത് തന്നെയാണ് ഉണ്ടക്കകത്ത് തന്നെ എന്നുവെച്ചാല് സാർ ഇതിനകത്ത് ഈ ഫസ്റ്റ് കാണിച്ച പിക്ചറില്ല ഇതില്ല സാർ പ്രൈമറി മാഗ്നറ്റിക് ഫീൽഡ് അതിന്റെ തൊട്ട് താഴെ തന്നെ ഗ്രേഡിയന്റ് കോയിൽ
ആ
വട്ടത്തിനകത്ത് തന്നെ അത് മൂന്ന് ഇതില് ആംഗിൾ ചെയ്തിരിക്കും ഈ കാണുന്നുണ്ട് സാർ ഈ റെഡ് കളറിലെ അത് ആ ഗ്രേഡിയന്റ് കോയിൽസ് ആണ് ആക്ച്വലി ഇതിന്റെ പുറത്ത് മറ്റേ പ്രൈമറി മാഗ്നറ്റിക് ഫീൽഡ്
എനിക്ക് അവിടെയാണ് എന്തിനാണ് ഇങ്ങനെ ഈ ഗ്രേഡിയന്റ് കോയിലിന്റെ പർപ്പസ് എന്താണെന്നുള്ളത് ഞാൻ ഇങ്ങനെ
ആലോചിക്കേണ്ടത്
റേഡിയോ ഫ്രീക്വൻസി കാരണം ക്ലിപ്പും ഒക്കെ ഉണ്ടാക്കുന്നത് എന്താണ് ഈ പ്രൈമറി മാഗ്നറ്റിക് ഫീൽഡും ഇതും തമ്മിലുള്ള ഡിഫറെന്റ് ഏരിയാസിലെ ഗ്രേഡ് ഓൾട്ടറേഷൻസ് മാഗ്നറ്റിക് ഫീൽഡ് സ്ട്രെങ്ത് ഉണ്ടാക്കാനാണ് As you said, metal is uniform magnetic
field.
ഓരോ സ്ഥലത്തും ഡിഫറൻസ് ഇൻ ദി മാഗ്നറ്റിക് സ്ട്രെങ്ത് വരുത്താൻ വേണ്ടിയാണ്
അതിൽ ചില ഇങ്ങനെ ഇസഡ് ആക്സിലുള്ള സ്ലൈസ് സെലക്ഷൻ ഗ്രേഡിയന്റ് ഫ്രീക്വൻസി എൻകോഡിംഗ് ഗ്രേഡിയന്റ് ഫേസിംഗ് ഇത് ഇങ്ങനെ ഒരു ടെർമിനോളജി കൊടുത്തിട്ടുണ്ട് ഇൻ ഡീറ്റെയിൽ പോയിട്ടില്ല അപ്പം ഓരോ ആക്സിസിലും അതെന്തോ സ്പെസിഫിക്കലി ഓരോ ഫംഗ്ഷൻ സിംഗിൾ
മാഗ്നറ്റിക്
അതെ സാർ ഇങ്ങനെ ഈ മൂന്ന് മൂന്ന് ഇതിൽ
മറ്റേതൊക്കെ ഒറ്റ യൂണിഫോം ഫീൽഡ് ആണെങ്കിൽ നമുക്ക് പല ഇത് കിട്ടൂല
കിട്ടൂല
വെച്ചിരിക്കുന്നു
അതിനും കൂടെയാണ് ഞാൻ ഇനിഷ്യലി സാർ അങ്ങനെ ഞാൻ മനസ്സിലാക്കിയത് ഞാന് ബട്ട് ഇത് കണ്ടപ്പോ അവര് ഇടയ്ക്ക് ഇങ്ങനെ പറയുന്നുണ്ടായിരുന്നു സ്ലൈസ് സെലക്ഷൻ ആണ് ഫസ്റ്റ് ഇത് പിന്നെ മറ്റേ കോയിലില് ഫ്രീക്വൻസിയും ഫേസ് എന്തൊക്കെ
സിമ്പിളായിട്ട് മനസ്സിലാക്കാൻ ഒറ്റ മാഗ്നറ്റിക് ഫീൽഡിനകത്ത് പറ്റൂല എന്നിട്ടാണ് പിന്നെ അതിന്റെ പുറത്ത് പിന്നെ ഒരു
So, when the RF impulse, it will flip the proton in a different direction. So, the net magnetization vector will turn towards the transverse plane. So, this is the longitudinal magnetization. So, when this flips, goes to this plane, this is the transverse plane. Or, it will create another transverse magnetization. So, initially, there will be a longitudinal magnetization. When we give the RF impulse, it will flip and another transverse magnetization will be created. Longitudinal is Z. Z, this is the Z axis and around me will be the magnet. That is the primary magnetic field. Head to foot will be the Z plane. And this axis is there now. That can even be X and Y. Both can be there. So in that plane. Actually for this thing, only these two planes are taken. We are not getting another plane like that. Everywhere it is system at two. So this is the transverse plane. That is the plane. Transverse is a magnetization.
So
imagine one bar of magnet like this and imagine another bar of magnet in this direction. So these two magnetic fields has an interference, something like that. ഇതില് വൈ ആണ് ഇതാണ് വൈ ഇത്
ലോഞ്ചിറ്റ്യൂഡിനൽ ട്രാൻസ്വേഴ്സ് പിന്നെ
ആക്ച്വലി സാർ ഈ
എക്സ്ആണോ
അതില് ഒരു അതിലൊരു എന്താ പറയുക സാർ ആ ഒരു പ്ലെയിൻ നമ്മൾ അറിയുന്നതിന് വലിയ അർത്ഥമില്ല
തോന്നുന്നു
കാരണം
ഇപ്പൊ
ഇങ്ങോട്ട് എക്സ് ആണെങ്കിൽ നേരെ പെർപെൻഡിക്കുലർ വൈ
ആയിരിക്കും
ഇങ്ങനെ ഇത് ഈ പ്ലെയിൻ
അത് ഈ ലോഞ്ചിറ്റ്യൂഡ് ഇങ്ങനെ കട്ട് ചെയ്യുമ്പോൾ ഇത് ലോഞ്ചിറ്റ്യൂഡ് ഇസ് ദിസ് വേ നിങ്ങൾ ഇവിടെ നിന്ന് ഇങ്ങനെ കട്ട് ചെയ്യുകയാണെങ്കിൽ ദിസ് ഇസ് അനദർ ആക്സസ് ട്രാൻസ്വേഴ്സ്
അത് കൊറോണലാണ് ആക്ച്വലി സാർ ഇമേജ് അക്വയർ ചെയ്യുന്ന സമയത്ത് ഇതിങ്ങനെ മൂന്ന് പ്ലെയിൻ ഉണ്ട് നമ്മള് മൂന്ന് ഇതില് സ്കൗട്ട് ഇമേജസ് ഒക്കെ എടുക്കും ഇങ്ങനെ മൂന്ന് പ്ലെയിൻ ഉണ്ട് പക്ഷെ ഈ നമ്മൾ ഈ മാഗ്നറ്റൈസേഷനും ഈ കോയിലും ഒക്കെ എക്സ്പ്ലെയിൻ ചെയ്യുമ്പോഴ് ഈ ഇസഡും ലോഞ്ചിറ്റ്യൂഡിനൽ മാഗ്നറ്റൈസേഷനും ട്രാൻസ്വേഴ്സ് മാഗ്നറ്റൈസേഷനും മാത്രമേ അവർ പറയും നമ്മൾ അങ്ങനെ മൂന്നാമത് ഒരു ആക്സിസിലെ ഒരു മാഗ്നറ്റൈസേഷൻ എന്നുള്ള രീതിയിൽ പറയുന്നത് ചിലപ്പം ഈ 3D MRIയിലൊക്കെ ആ ലെവലില് പ്ലെയിൻസിനെ ഡിവൈഡ് ചെയ്യുന്ന ഒരു പിക്ചർ ഉണ്ട് ഇങ്ങനെ പ്ലെയിൻസ് ഉണ്ട് സാർ ഇങ്ങനെ അത് MRI വ്യൂസിൽ വരും ഷോർട്ട് ആക്സിസ് ഹൊറിസോണ്ടൽ ഇങ്ങനെ കൊറോണൽ ഈ സെയിം പിക്ചർ ആണ്
The advantage of MRI is that you can use it in any direction. ഈ ക്ലാസിക്കൽ ഇതൊക്കെ ഉണ്ടെങ്കിൽ നമുക്ക് ചൂസ് ചെയ്യാം ബ്യൂട്ടി ഓഫ് ദി MRI കമ്പയർഡ് ടു ദി എക്കോ ആൻഡ് എക്കോയില് നമുക്ക് ഫിക്സഡ് യൂസ് ചെയ്യുള്ളൂ ലോങ് ആക്സിന്റെ ലോങ് ആക്സിസ് ആവും ഇവിടെ നമുക്ക് മാറ്റാൻ പറ്റൂല ഇപ്പൊ കൊറോണ ആൻജിയോഗ്രാഫി ചെയ്യുകയാണെങ്കിൽ നമുക്ക് ഇന്ന വ്യൂസിൽ എടുക്കാൻ പറ്റില്ല ചേഞ്ച് ദ വ്യൂസ് ആ വ്യൂവിൽ കിട്ടുന്ന പിക്ചർ അല്ലേ ഇതിനകത്ത് യു ക്യാൻ മോഡിഫൈ യുവർ ഇമേജസ് ബൈ ചേഞ്ചിങ് ഓൾ ദിസ് വെക്ടേഴ്സ്
അത് മോസ്റ്റ്ലി ആ ഗ്രേഡിയന്റ് കോയിൽ വെച്ചിട്ടുള്ള ഗ്രേഡിയന്റ് കോയിലിന്റെ അഡ്വാൻറ്റേജ് ആണ്
എങ്ങനെ വേണമെങ്കിലും നിങ്ങൾക്ക് മാറ്റാൻ പറ്റും ഇപ്പൊ നമ്മുടെ ഏരിയ ഓഫ് ഇൻട്രസ്റ്റ് തന്നെ നമുക്ക് മാറ്റിയൊരു പിക്ചർ ആയിട്ട് ചിലപ്പോൾ കിട്ടും നമുക്ക് അതൊന്നും എക്കോ കിട്ടില്ല അപ്പൊ യു ആർ ഓൺലി ദി ലെഫ്റ്റ് വെന്റിക്കുലർ ഔട്ട്ലുക നമുക്ക് അത് കിട്ടില്ല ഇവർക്കിട്ട് ഓൺലി ഇത് കോമ്പോസിറ്റ് പിക്ചർ മാത്രമേ കിട്ടുള്ളൂ മറ്റേത് ഓരോന്നും നമുക്ക് ചെയ്യാൻ പറ്റും ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് സപ്പോസ് ടു ബി ദി ബെസ്റ്റ് ഇമ്പോർട്ടന്റ് അഡ്വാൻറ്റേജ് ഓഫ് MRI
So, when the RF impulse is given, it will flip to a higher energy level and will process in phase. So, it will create a transverse magnetization. Now, when this transverse magnetization is created, these misdirected protons, the protons which are misdirected, will go back to their original magnetic field, that is the B0. So, that going back to the original magnetic field is what we call as the relaxation. So the relaxation also there are different things there are more into this relaxation so this relaxation we measure it in two direction that is when it relaxes back to the original magnet that is the B0 that is we call as a longitudinal relaxation or that is it is going back to the longitudinal magnetism that original thing and in the transverse plane and there are differences so I'll just explain what is T1 That is going back to the original magnetic field is the this thing first relaxation or and the time taken to go back to the original magnetic field is the T1 that is the time duration it takes to go back to the original that is in T1 the difference between T1 and T2 is T1 it will go back to the original magnetic field by releasing energy and these protons will release energy into the nearby molecules and it will be molecules like the tissue structures so these tissue structures are having a lattice configuration so this energy is delivered to this lattices so that is why we call this T2-1 relaxation otherwise called as a spin lattice interaction that is it is a spin lattice interaction so in T1 relaxation this release of energy differs by various tissue present in there So if it is water, water will have a long T1, that is to relax into this thing, the water, the hydrogen in the water will have a long T1 and this water will appear as dark in T1, whereas the fat will have a short T1 and it will appear as a bright. So that is what is T1 relaxation. So here we can see that this is Z is a longitudinal magnetization. So when this gradient, this RF is applied, it creates a transverse magnetization. So we can see that the longitudinal, the length of that longitudinal magnetization also has come down, decreased, which is given to the transverse magnetization. So that it means that the primary magnetic field strength will decrease when this transverse magnetization is created. So this transverse magnetization will be slowly going back to the primary. So we can see that it has gained its original length, that is the original this thing. So the longitudinal magnetization is completely recovered now. So during this phase, it will give energy to the nearby particles. So that is T1 relaxation. And when it gives energy to the nearby particles, these particles will release radio frequency signals, which is detected by this RF coil, and that is interpreted, that we'll go next. Now T2 relaxation is different. Even though this T1 relaxation and T2 relaxation, we may think that it is same, but it's actually different. So T2 relaxation is, there is no energy that is delivered, but it is actually T2 in the transverse spine, there are several small multiple magnetic fields which cancel each other. So that is how the magnetic field in the transverse spine, that is the transverse magnetization, disappears, or we call that decaying of the transverse magnetization. So that is like these protons will bump on each other and it will cancel the magnetic field of each other. So that is why we call the T2 relaxation, otherwise called as spin-spin interaction. Or T2 relaxation, we can even assume it has to be a decay, not like the T1 relaxation. T1 is, it is going back to the original thing, whereas this is like small multiple magnetic fields that bump on each other and cancel each other. So that is T2 relaxation. So the time for relaxation, generally for T1, it is around 63, when it achieves 63% of the original magnetic field, we say that the longitudinal magnetism is complete. For T2, that much is not required, around 30% something. We can say that the transverse magnetization has decayed off. So this is the difference between T1 and T2.
From what I understood, I think T1 is the time taken for 63%
of the time taken from going back to
the
original.
Yes, that is T1. Not the total time. Okay, it is the 63 time taken for
actually because it's a considered to be weak magnetic, multiple small weak magnetic thing.
So as you earlier told, actually when an RF frequency is applied, everything gets in phase, and once you release the RF energy, when you store the RF energy, it will go out of phase.
That I am coming, sir. T2 relaxation, in T2 relaxation, this phase and phase out is happening. So,
and it's not a color that actually, color is given by something else. It has been programmed so that the materials which are having a longer T1 will be colored black. And that we have programmed like that. Okay. It's not something which MRI is doing by itself.
MRI is color.
Color coding is given by
the machine. Actually, they give different grades of shape, different shades of gray, for based on the relaxation level. So the T2, when in this decaying process, the protons which were spinning in phase will start to spin out of phase. That is, protons. So when it starts spinning out of phase, the decaying process will happen. Small several magnetic field, and it's called spin-to-spin interaction, and the magnetism will cancel each other, and this is inhomogeneity of the local magnetic field. This is one terminology we come across in the T2 this thing. So it will depend on the inhomogeneity of the local magnetic field, that is whether it's homogeneous or not. So in T2, water will have a long T2 and water will appear bright. I'm coming to the picture. So this is the thing that the transverse magnetization going back. The protons here are in phase, then going out of phase, and completely out of phase, there is no transverse magnetization left. So that is decayed off. So that is a T2 relaxation. So there is one more thing called as T2 star, which is a small modification of T2, which is different from T2 actually. So based on the inhomogeneity of the external magnetic field which it told, there is a T2 star also, that is this T2 relaxation plus the field inhomogeneity. details I'm not sure, but just to understand that there is something called T2 star other than T2. So when we get a MRI report or something, we see all these things, that is T1, T2, the T2 star. Then there is a concept, there is TR and TE, that is time to repetition. TE is time to echo. This I'll come in the next slide. Then TI is time to inversion. So these three is another three terminologies, and based on the T1 and T2 we get T1 weighted image, T2 weighted image. Then there is another type of image that we can get based on the density of these protons, which is proton density image. That is also one more MRI this thing. So when we think of cardiac MRI, we need not bother much about T1 and T2 actually. Why? Because in cardiac, for the brain imaging we may need T1 T2, but cardiac MRI, the about 90% it is T1 imaging. And there are only certain instances when we do a T2 image, that is I told that T2 water appears bright. So in myocardial edema conditions, then in iron deposition, these conditions we use T2. In myocardial edema we use T2 imaging, when we want to look for myocarditis, that will show myocardial edema, so we look for the bright water content there. Then for iron deposition cardiac imaging, that is where we use T2 star, we look for the iron deposition. So the time TR and TE, so time to repeat, TR is time to repeat, that is when we give a radio frequency pulse, so we give the next radio frequency pulse after a definite time. So that time is called the time to repeat, that is start of one RF pulse and the start of the next RF pulse, that is a time to repeat, TR. And TE is time to echo, that is we give the pulse and the time we taken to receive a signal from that is the time to echo. And so based on the TE and TR, we create certain sequences, that is for short TR and TE, that is for T1 weighed images we use a short TR and a short TE, for T2 weighed images we use a long TR and a long TE, for proton density images we use a long TR and short TE. That is just the concept. So based on, by altering this only we get different weighed images. So just to the summary of what we told, that is T1 weighed image, water appears dark, whereas in T2 weighed image, water appears bright. So to see the general anatomy, suppose we are doing a brain imaging, we do a T1 imaging. But if there is pathology, that is when there is any pathology happens, then naturally it will have more of edema, more water content may go into that pathology. So in that scenario, T2 weighed image, because water appears much bright, that will give better contrast. So for T2 we use more for with the pathology. So just to show an example, in the suppose we are doing a brain imaging, here we can see that the CSF, which is more of water, is appearing dark. So this is the T1 image, this MRI. Comparing to this, we can see that the CSF here and all is appearing bright. So we can pretend that this is a T2 image. So the opposite is for fat. Just we can remember by like the T2 water appears bright, T2 image water appears bright. So the relaxation occurs, it releases energy, there is a signal that is given back. So this signal is encoded and converted by various sophisticated systems, which will give this is the total signal that we get. So it will appear like this. This is transferred by what we call as a Fourier transformation into an image. So this is
Fourier transformation.
So just to summarize the MRI physics, so there is a primary magnetic field, then we have gradient coils below that in three planes, then to that primary and a secondary magnet we send a radio frequency signal that will trigger and move these protons out. Then the moved protons will go back to the originating magnetic field when this signal is turned off. That is, we give the signal for a short time, and when this RF signal is
second 1/1000 is for the signal. And
999
is for receiving.
So, so when it is turned off, it will go back to the, so that will release a signal that will be detected by this RF coil, and there's a relaxation in two planes, the longitudinal magnetization as well as the transverse magnetization. So the magnetic field strength expressed in Tesla, so we have available 1.53 Tesla. So higher the Tesla, the higher the resolution, or more resolution of the cardiac structures. So 1 Tesla, the magnetic field strength at the Earth's magnetic equator is 0.0000 this much, 305 Tesla. So we are creating 1 Tesla at the Earth's magnetic field. It is only this. So it's about this much times around about the Earth's magnetic field. And one more thing is the MRI. When we go to MRI room, the magnet is always on. We have to think. That is. The primary magnetic field will be generated with the, when the current is passed, when the machine is turned on. But even if the machine is turned off also, that magnetization will be remaining there. So even if you enter a MRI room where the machine is off also, we should think that there is still magnetization within the room. So we should not take in metallic particles there. So these are the hazards that can occur. Everything can be pulled into the, any metallic object can be pulled into the magnetic. So coming to after the thing, now what are the advantages of cardiac MRI? There is lack of ionizing radiation and like the CT or this thing. There is free choice of imaging plane, that is we can do it in any tomographic plane. There is tissue characterization is much better compared to the other imaging modality. Qualitative and quantitative variation of the motion of both the blood and myocardium, that is the movement itself, we can obtain cine images. Just like we have for the echo, we can watch the exact movement of the cardiac structures with very good resolution. And the regional perfusion also, that is by the gadolinium enhancement you can assess the regional perfusion. So these are all the this thing, that is everything which we do with an echo we can do with the cardiac MRI, plus there are many other things which we can do which the echo cannot do also. That is ventricular size, morphology, function, the systolic function, diastolic function, the myocardial mass estimation, we can estimate it to the very precise value, the size and structure, the valve morphology we can see very clearly, the position of the valves we can see very clearly, the flow also, that is when there is a regurgitation or a stenosis, the flow velocity we can determine with accuracy, just like we do the spectral Doppler. In MRI also we can determine the exact velocity like this thing. Then infarction, when there is MI, we can assess the regional wall motion abnormality very clearly, just like we do the echo. Perfusion, I told. Then
so infiltration.
Tissue characters.
Which the echo will not be able to do.
Then we can even do the MR angiography also. That is a coronary vessel, this thing also we can do. So this is just the various this thing. So limitation is claustrophobia, seen in 5% of patients. Then the implanted device, this thing issue will be there. So that indications, the most. So the most common indication, these are the common by percentage which has been done in abroad centers, where so they have most commonly done for heart failure cardiomyopathy assessment, 31%. This is just the actual value which has been done in a premier institute in US. There this thing, ischemia evaluation 50%, vascular valve assessment, so everything we can do. More commonly they are doing for assessment of cardiomyopathy and ischemia evaluation. That is 8%, they have done 8%.
So, check out the OPD interval.
Oh,